Although TAS is very rare, I think is increasing month by month. And I want to show our experience. I am a clinical doctor, the director of the Northwestern Uveitis Center of Italy. So some colleagues called me because of the differential diagnosis to this syndrome. We know the definition, we know that it recognizes multiple causes and association of causes. And the characteristic of the symptoms and the signs were well discovered by previous speakers. I want to show only our experience because at last we arrived to have the right the problem that was the viscoelastic. On the 15 June 2015, we had 8 eyes all together in the same session with an abnormal and unexpected anterior chamber inflammation after a normal phaco, uncomplicated phacos. And that was the moment that they called me because I had to give them the right differential diagnosis from uveitis, endophthalmitis, and TAS. So we stopped the surgery for 1 week. We changed some procedures, only single dose eye drops, no cefuroxime injection in anterior chamber, gloves without a talc. We performed after 10 days surgery, but other 4 eyes with anterior chamber reaction. So we stopped adrenaline BSS, and you can see that the problem is very important if you see the cornea of these eyes. We stopped newly, we changed something, but other 17 cases in a, during a week, 3 with severe signs. And I can show the eyes we had. So we sent the instrument to the lab analysis, we changed the detergents, we used only single-use instruments, and the important thing, we did an Excel file putting all the data and all the variables of our patients, and you can see the Excel file. And we made a new differential diagnosis, but the typical aspect, it was of TAS. We did the TAPS for infections in these 17 cases, but other 6 mild to severe cases in 1 day appeared. So we did a permanent stop of our surgery because something was wrong. We did a new analysis of the cell file, and then at last we added that 32 on 35 cases had in common the same batch of the viscoelastic 1.6% hyaluronic acid substance. And this is one of the eyes, another eye, and these are the warning to the Italian ministry after the first cases, the answer of the Italian Health Ministry, the lab concerning the check of our instrument, it was negative, and also the report of the company producing the viscoelastic substance. My comment is nobody asked us to examine the batch we had in our department. And all the TAPs, we performed 24 TAP, anterior chamber TAPs were negative for bacteria and for fungi. And why our delay? 1 month we had with this, we lived with this nightmare because we use our nursing to organize and write all the things and put the label of what we use during surgery. And the nurse put it randomly, so put the label of another viscoelastic material in the first cases. And so we did a mistake in that. from the end of July of 2015 until today, by replacing and changing the viscoelastic substance, we don't have any other case of tests. But it's important to see that we had severe sequelae. On 35 cases, 30 eyes recovered vision in 20 days, about, with highly daily dosages of steroid eye drops. But the 14% resulted in severe sequelae. 4 eyes had a persistent corneal edema, and 1 eye persistent high IOP. And 7 eyes reported persistent pupillary abnormalities. My take-home message is, look at first at the viscoelastic you use, because in 2017 related literature, many reports from the viscoelastic from different companies. And the other, make an Excel file and put all the data, because at last you will find what is the matter. Thank you.